As Fairy Queen, I will relate and bring you fully up to date with what is happening to us here.
Controller ruler, most benign, is this already for a time?
When festive celebrations start and bells ring out to cheer the heart, a new season is welcomed in, a bright and happy year begins.
On blot remains, scream which meantime.
Best of the land of Mercerine.
Off roam to darken King Cole's throne. But perhaps tonight she'll leave us alone to start our pantomime in style.
Oh, no, I won't. Not by a mile.
It's that witchy fiend again to spoil my very careful plan.
Rhubarb, that's what I say to you. Some evil magic I will do, unless you let me have my way and marry the hero in this play.
Marry the hero? Whatever next? That would make a pretty text.
It's time the baddies ruled the roost and gave my evil schemes a boost.
Evil partnered up with good. No, I can't have understood. To such a thing I'll not agree.
Well, Fairy Sundial, we shall see. Reject my plan and rue the day, for I'll marry Hickory anyway and make the next new season mine, and bad shall rule for all that time. Ha!
Here. Oh, I do apologise. But let the curtain now arise.
All calendars, clocks, and computers are set and ready to Go, man, go.
Good, good.
We need everything to go smoothly. Can't deal with any hitches now, can we?
My son, young Hickory, has been working on all the digital clocks and everything, Majesty. These young people, they understand these things so much better than we do.
Indeed, indeed. I can't even set the video recorder without my grandson doing it for me. Most humiliating. Well, he is only three. Oh, he says it's 3.5. I don't know. Anyway, last time I tried to do it, I got Delia Smith instead of the cup final. Oh, very embarrassing. Soufflés instead of scorers. Oh, what a disaster. Where's young Hickory then?
Come on, young Hickory, to the Royal Bath Lady.
He should be around here somewhere. Ah, here he is.
Hi, everyone. Hello, Majesty. Hello, Princess.
Hello, Hickory.
Oh, stop it, you two.
Yes, old Hickory.
Ask him now.
Come on. Okay, I will. Majesty, we, both of us, would...
Not now, young Hickory. We're doing the greetings, everyone, bit. That sort of thing.
Majesty, I just wanted to say that my son, young Hickory here, is now able to take over full responsibility for the royal timekeeping.
You've taught him well, but he does interrupt
us. If I may continue, Majesty. What with a new beginning this year, it seemed like a good time to hand over to him. I'm getting rather old now, and I do tend to... drop off at times.
You're becoming a bit of a dicky, Hickory Dickory, eh?
Very droll, Magistrate.
It's the way I tell them.
Not really, no. Anyway, as I was saying... Oh, dear, what was I saying? Oh, yes, these modern contraptions...
I tried to wear one once myself. Tears to my eyes. I walked all funny.
No, not that sort of contraption, Majesty. I meant digital what's-its, modems in things.
Oh, we're getting too old for all this modern stuff, Hickory. Why, some people have even started to call me Old King Cole.
No!
That's true.
Well, Father, does young Hickory get the job then?
Job? Better time for a new beginning. When the clocks announce the new year, young Hickory shall become the official nurseryland timekeeper. And we can pass it on to the younger generation. And a well-earned rest. Spot of fishing, that sort of thing.
Ah, most welcome, Majesty.
Thank you, Father.
Oh, don't mention it. I think I'd better make one of those royal thingy things. Now, what do you call them?
A royal pardon, Majesty.
A pardon? No. It's a royal.
Royal jelly, Your Majesty.
Not now, thank you. I've just had breakfast.
A royal proclamation, Majesty.
A royal proclamation. I'm glad I thought of that. Right. I hereby proclaim that being of sound mind... can you stop interrupting? Now, as I was saying, I hereby proclaim that at the advent of the new year, young Hickory here shall become the official royal timekeeper. There will be a public holiday, a day of celebrations, bags of champers, that sort of thing! Now, come along, you lot.
Make way for the royal personage!
Make way for the royal personage!
Make way! Well then, Hickory, here we are.
Yes, but I still haven't been able to ask your father if I may marry you. He doesn't give me a chance.
One step at a time, Hickory.
Yes, but he always stops me with, not now, too busy, that sort of thing.
Hey, that's treason, that is.
I don't care.
they lock me up in the tower, at least I get to see more of you.
Not if they chop your head off, you won't.
Oh dear.
No, I won't let them do that.
No, I meant...
Look, cheer up. You'll soon be promoted to official royal timekeeper.
Yes, at least your father agreed to that without much fuss.
All my hours of careful training have finally paid off.
Oh, and you'll be training me when we're married?
Of course not, Hickory. Whatever gave you that idea? I wouldn't dream of it.
I wonder.
Well, if you're having second thoughts.
No!
No, Hickory, I like you just the way you are.
That's the way it is for me, too.
I'm just a clown who picks you up each time you're down. Oh, baby. Oh, baby. Give me just a taste of love to build my hopes upon. You know you've got the power, girl, to keep me holding on. So now you've got the best of me. Come on and take the rest of me. Oh, baby.
Surgery. Oh, I've got a terrible pain. It comes all the way up this side this morning. It goes all the way up here, then it goes all round there, and then it goes all down round there. I'm a martyr to it, I am really. Oh dear. I don't suppose I shall see another new year. Aww. Still, I'm here now. Evans, there's a lot of you here this morning. Are you all in the queue? Oh, dear, I shall never get seen. Oh, dear, what number are you? There must be an epidemic or something. Mind you, you do look a bit dodgy. Doesn't she look a bit dodgy? Yeah. Stick your tongue out. Ah. All of you, put your tongues out. Let's have a look. Oh. How rude. You must be that lot from Amptill. Oh, well. Right, well, I am called Dame Megabyte. Now that's short for Big Mouth. I don't know why they call me that, but
I'm old Mr. Ickery's housekeeper, and he sent me out here to warm you all up a bit. So, what I've got here, there's a peppermint. Right, now, you have a suck and pass it on. Actually, really, I've got quite a lot of things in here. Let's see what we've got. Oh, we'll have a few of those around the room and see what we do with them. My goodness. Who's all these lucky people here? I'm not going right up there at the back. That's far too far to walk in my state of health. My goodness.
Well done.
I think I've nearly run out now.
Oh, there's one, there's another. There you are, that one.
No, that's the end of it. They've all gone. No more sweets left.
Time.
I think I'm having one of those tropical delusions.
Why can't you come on like normal people?
I don't think it's real.
Oh, get off!
Folks, meet Malden's answer to the Loch Ness Monster. Give her a big boo.
Don't tell them to do that.
Well, I just did tell them to do that. But they didn't do it very loud, did they?
No, luckily for you, they didn't.
Can't you give her a bigger boo than that? Yeah, that's better.
How dare you.
Anyway, who the blue blazes are you?
Blue?
Aye.
Blue? Are you colourblind? Look at these. They're green, dear. Green.
Oh, yes. And now you mention it, your face has got a bit of mildew as well. Is that why you're here? You'll have to go to the back of the queue. All this lot are waiting. She's number 79 and they haven't started yet.
What is she talking about?
Mind you, that does look a bit nasty. Doesn't that look a bit nasty?
Yes.
Oh, they think you look a bit nasty too.
Nasty? You haven't seen nasty yet. Just wait till I get started.
Don't come no near me. I don't want to catch whatever it is you've got.
I should hate to end up looking like that.
I'll turn ugly in a minute.
Oh, I thought you already had. Here, I bet you're here to see that nice Dr. Hazlitt, haven't you? Aren't you? Oh, he's got a lovely bedside manner. Mind you, I know what he'll tell you. You want to know, don't you?
No.
Yes, I thought you would. He'll say, what you want to do is rub your face down twice a day with a bit of coarse sandpaper. That will get rid of that rust.
I'm no witch, you oaf. I'm supposed to look like this. I'm the one that makes everything go pear-shaped.
Oh, don't look at me, it's already happened.
I'm the Green Witch. They call me Meantime. Do you get it, Green Witch, Meantime? No. Well, laugh then! Come on, they're going to be hard work tonight.
Green Witch, Meantime, eh? Haven't you got no dome to go to?
I'm looking for that nice young hickory. I saw him the other day down at the co-op. God, I could love him to bits. So I decided to marry him, turn over a new leaf in the new year, settle down, do some domestics and stop being horrible, and live happily ever after. It's love, you see. Love changes everything.
She sings even worse than she looks.
Anyway, who'd want to marry you? You'd have even less chance than me.
I'm a good catch, I am. Not many people can do magic like me. I can provide anything anyone could want. I just say, hey presto, and it's there.
There'd have to be some compensation being married to that.
Oh, shut up, you old flea bag.
Anyway, you've got no hope. Young Master Hickory already has his eyes on someone else.
Oh, he hasn't, has he?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's not fair. I hate pantomimes. There's no justices here. I bet she's some silly, pretty, empty-headed young thing. Not one of them Spice Girls, is it?
No, but not only is she young and pretty, but she's the king's daughter as well.
Well, he won't fancy her if I turn her into a frog. You see, you try and turn over a new leaf, and this happens. Everything could have been so nice. It looks as though I'd have to turn ugly after all. I might even stop the clocks.
Oh, you can't do that.
Oh, yes, I can.
Oh, no, you can't.
Oh, yes, I can.
Oh, no, you can't.
Oh, yes, I can, and it's time for you to go. This is my spot, so blow! Meantime, now I'll show you how I'm going to woo young Hickory. He won't be able to resist. I feel pretty, feel pretty. I feel pretty and witty and gay. And I pity any girl that isn't me today. I feel charming, oh so charming. It's alarming how charming I feel. Pretty girl in that mirror there. Who could that attractive girl be? Such a pretty dress, such a pretty face, such a pretty smile, such a pretty me. I feel pretty, oh so pretty. I feel pretty and witty and gay. I'm in love with a pretty, wonderful boy.
Different this year. Each time I come on stage, I want you to cheer, hooray, like that, or I'll turn you into something horrible. You look even worse than you do now. Can you do that cheer, hooray?
No.
What? Did someone say no? Watch it. Right, we'll have a little practice. I'll go off, and when I come back on, you'll all cheer, hooray. That's no good, you useless lot. Don't you know how to cheer? You must be from Alameda Middle School. I've a good mind not to let you see my little helper. Do you want to see him? Well, you don't deserve it. He's all lovely and cuddly, just like me. Come on, Virus, your fans are waiting. Just look at it. Looks like something that's been left out of the fridge all night. He's Virus. You've heard of him. He gets into your computers, eats your silicon chips, and spoils your games. Liven yourself up, will you?
I'm tired. It's hard work getting around all those computer things. I'm fed up with eating silicon chips. Why can't I have some silicon fish to go with?
Fed up with chips? No one gets fed up with chips. These kids eat nothing else.
But these chips are all tough and crunchy. I broke a tooth on one this morning. Look.
Oh, get off. Must have been cooked by Dame Megabyte.
I heard that.
Not funny. I'm tired.
Anyone want to give him the kiss of life? Oh, yes, you do.
Oh, no, we don't.
And I've got a chill.
Virus has got a chill.
With complications.
What complications? Ah.
It's gone to me head.
So will my broomstick in a minute. Germs always attack the weakest part. They have a great time rattling around in there. Now, I need to do something about you. You can't help me in this state.
I can't help you in this state.
I just said that.
What do you want me to do anyway?
It would help if you came out of your coma. Now, I've just heard that young Hickory is sweet on that princess.
How do you know that?
I read it in the witch report.
Oh, we're very funny. So they're in love, eh? Ah, that's very romantic.
Romantic? Yeah, whose side are you on?
I can hear wedding bells already.
Oh, they're not wedding bells. That's the ringing in your ears from that clump on the head.
What clump on the head?
This one! Anyway, nothing kills a good romance like getting married. You ask them lot.
I don't see what I can do.
No, nor do I. Not like that. Come on, droopy drawers.
I get a complex if you start calling me names. I get all knotted and twisted.
Oh, come on. And don't boo us when we go off.
Boo!
I said! Here, just you wait. Hi, everybody! We're Tick and Tock. Say hello, Tick and Tock.
Hello, Tick and Tock.
That's not very loud. Have you all got sore throats?
Yes.
Shall we give them another try?
Go on then. You have to shout louder this time or we'll both go home.
Who said good?
Ready?
Hi, Tick and Tock.
Hi, Tick and Tock.
That's better.
We're both assistants to Old Hickory.
We've got key jobs.
We wind the clocks up with them.
And we train all the clocks to go tick tock, see?
Well, how would you know they were still going if they didn't do that?
See? They didn't realise, did they?
If it wasn't for us, everything would come to a complete stop.
Right.
We get all the clocks together on a training course.
And I go tick.
And I go tock, see?
Until they get the hang of it.
Mind you, it can get very, very boring.
Yeah, so sometimes she goes
tick
and I go top.
Just to make it more interesting, see?
We're real devils, we are.
Don't tell anyone.
We have a little mouse to help us. He runs up the clock when they strike one.
Should be around here somewhere.
Mouse! Mouse!
He can't hear you. Will you help call him? Anybody goes near it?
Yes.
Your secret's safe with them, Mouse.
Right, we'd better get back to work. You won't forget to shout out loud if anybody goes near Mouse's secret, will you?
No.
And you'll say hi, Tick and Tock, whenever you see us?
Yes.
Are you sure that's not too complicated?
Well, now that's sorted, we'd better get back to work. There's lots to do.
Yeah, there's no rest when you're working at the clock shop.
Thank you.
shop. Whoa, whoa, yeah, yeah. Working at the clock shop, yeah. Come on now and tick-tock with me, clock shop.
Sing it with feeling, girl.
At the clock shop, yeah.
Some of the work gets kinda hard. This ain't no place to be if you plan on being a star.
Let me tell you, it's always cool. And the boss don't mind sometimes if you act like a fool. At the clock shop, whoa, whoa, yeah, yeah. Shop.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
At the clock shop, yeah.
Work and work, those clocks always seem to stop today.
Work and work,
keep those cogs and wheels clicking.
Work and work, my fingers to the bone. Work and work, is it time to go home?
Hey, get your clock checked today.
At the clock shop, whoa, whoa, yeah, yeah. At the clock shop, yeah. Come on now and tick-tock with me, clock shop.
Sing it with feeling, girl.
At the clock shop, yeah.
Hey, get your clock checked today.
Wound up and you don't have to pay, yeah. Let's keep that green with your face.
Fish. Anyway, you'll be all right this time.
What are you going to do?
I'm going
going to turn you into one of those caped crusader thingies. Yes, a superbug.
Oh no, that takes lots of energy. Won't I have to climb up walls and fly about and fight penguins and spider women and things? That's tiring, Natalie.
Don't you ever stop moaning? Now, let's have a nasty spell. I said spell, you fool, spell! You just can't get the staff these days. Right, get ready, virus. Your life is about to change. Dozy virus, time to blow into Cape Crusader. Go! Superbug!
Shall I dispose of them, boss? Because I'm Superbug.
See, kids, just put your underpants on over your trousers and you can be like him.
We don't want no trouble out of you lot.
That's more like it. Now, I've got a job for you to do.
Righto, boss.
Hey, come back, you fool. I haven't told you what it is yet.
Ah, but you don't have to, boss.
Don't I?
No, I have supernatural powers. So I know what you're thinking, before you even think it.
Wow, that is clever. Well, go on, tell me what I really, 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 really want.
What you require is for me to infiltrate the enemy, to seek out and destroy, by all means by which a good new year can begin. To it, to hinder and retard all clocks and watches and calendars that be used to indicate the new year has begun. Until such times as young Hickory can be persuaded to marry you instead of the Princess Curly. Over and out.
Well, clap then. Did I really think all that? Yes, I suppose I did. Carry on, Superbug.
Can I get my friend to help me?
Your friend? Who's that?
He's my assistant, C.D. Ron.
C.D. Ron? Well, let's have a look at him then.
Come on then!
Good thinking, Superbug! Hi everyone!
Oi, you're not supposed to be friendly with them. They're the enemy.
Sorry, but they look rather nice.
Nice? They're not nice! They're horrible! You're horrible, aren't you?
He'll be all right when I've trained him up a bit.
Well, make sure you do. We don't want him mucking things up.
Right. I shall begin with small clocks and watches and work my way up. I shall become invisible and wait here.
Wow, that is clever. Wouldn't you like to be able to do that? Now, you, where are you?
I'm over here, boss.
Right, you get on with your work while I go and choose myself a nice trousseau. You can come and help me. Now, where shall me and Hickory go for our honeymoon? Ah! Get out of my way! And don't boo.
Fiddlers. You saw us before just now, didn't you?
Yes.
Well, you're seeing us again now.
We are the King's Fiddlers.
Always on the fiddle.
We fiddle anything. Income tax.
Car tax.
Tin tax. Pocket money. Fiddlers by royal appointment. We fiddle our ways to the top jobs.
Here, don't tell them that.
Why not? It's true.
Yeah, but you don't have to tell everybody.
I'm only telling them.
Pay no attention. He's a few sandwiches short of a picnic.
I'm not. I have, you know, a very musical bent.
Well, there's no answer to that, is there?
Yes, there is. I'm very musical. The piano left a big impression on me.
On his brains?
You can still see the impression, look! Leave off.
Right, now look, I'm going to show you a lot of trick. Now, you see this watch? You've got the big hand, and you've got the little hand. The big hand's the big one. Here, my watch has stopped. Little Free, lend me your watch a minute. Right, now you see this watch? Very similar, I've got the big hand, you've got the little hand, the big... Yeah, your watch ain't working either.
Well, it was working when I gave it to you. What have you done to it?
I haven't done anything to it. Look, the big hand stopped moving. It fiddled too, lend me your watch a minute.
No fear, just seeing what we've done to his watch.
I ain't done nothing to it. How am I going to show them the trick without a watch?
I don't care, you're not going to ruin my watch.
Funny that. Both watches stopping at exactly the same time. I wonder how that happened. Do you know? Who? What?
Doug? But there's nobody there.
There's nobody there. Look, I think they're having us on.
Yeah.
I'll show them a trick. I'll use my watch. Right, now you see my watch? Big hand, little hand, not his.
It. My watch just stopped working.
I stopped it.
Here! Who said that?
I did.
Ha 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 ha! That's really clever, that is. You said that without moving your lips.
I said it.
Oh, do you think you could teach me? Do it again.
I didn't say anything.
Oh, I saw your lips move that time.
Is that like they're trying to scare us?
Is it you?
No.
I don't believe it. No. It is you, isn't it?
It was me.
Who did that?
Don't look at us.
You two, go and stand over there.
You see, it was me.
Here, fancy getting scared and running off like that.
No, he's not brave like us, is he?
No.
Did I tell you when I took out a dentistry with only one hand once?
Who would want to go out of a century with only one hand?
Yeah, they're thinking about that.
Did I ever tell you about the time I saved the whole platoon from a horrible fate?
Oh no, what happened?
I shot the cook.
You won't be so brave in a minute.
Yeah, don't do that.
I didn't do anything and take your hand off my shoulder.
I haven't got my hands on your shoulder. What?
One,
what?
Two, three. Ow!
Here, where are you going? We ain't shown him the trick yet!
I'll show you a good trick. Watch this.
Here, where did you come from?
Now, watch this.
Here, where did he go? Stayed in.
I'm behind you.
I've had enough of this.
Ha 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 ha! Ha ha ha! Anyone scared of Superbug? Oh! Be quiet! You'll give me indigestion. Oh no! Mice! I ain't mice! Don't let him get me!
Well, really,
What a tiresome witch, introducing such a hitch. Her superbug could problems cause and put our good new year on pause. Now, we must put on our thinking caps and circumvent such mishaps. Good day.
That must be last week's ratatouille-ouli. Very nice. I make it with real rats, you see. Now, let us see. There, that's better. Now then, two dollops of cooking sherry. Well, thank goodness for that. One dollop. Two dollops. Lovely. Now then, I shall never get the hang of this cooking lark. No matter how hard I try, and I've got to make something special for the New Year's celebrations. Something they can actually eat. No matter how many of these cooking programmes I watch, they still can't get the spoon out of my custard. This isn't anything special. This is just for the mouse. He likes me to cook him up this strange stuff. It's mouldy cheese with dead flies, caterpillars, finely chopped worms. Very, very tasty, he says it is. Would you like to try some? Are you sure? Don't blame you, it smells horrible. I'll have a nice piece of fish, I think. I don't think I like the way it's looking at me. It doesn't look very happy. It's going to look even less happy in a minute. Here, it moved. Can't you sit still when I'm trying to chop your head off? Right, stay. It did it again. Must be a flying fish. Well, I'm not chasing that all over the house.
Dame Megabyte, I'm hungry. What's to eat?
Well, not fish for a start.
Good, I ate fish. I don't like fish being cooked.
No, nor did he.
What?
Oh, Hickory, you are a pest. Can't you see I'm busy? I'm trying to make something tasty for old Master Hickory's breakfast.
You're not giving him that, are you? It smells horrible.
No, of course not. That's for Mouse.
Good, but I'm still hungry.
You don't eat enough, that's the trouble. It's what comes of being in love, they say.
Really? Mm-hmm. Well, they'll have to rewrite the textbooks when they see me tucking into this then, won't they?
Why are you so hungry anyway?
I've got to ask the king an important question.
Oh, about the Princess Colleen, I suppose.
Yes.
Yes, well that can wait.
No, it can't!
Yes, it can. Now you're here, you can help me.
But I'm eating the princess in a minute, so I can't keep her waiting.
Never mind about that, she'll keep. Give this a stir and keep an eye on it while I go and ask the chickens for a few eggs.
But I can't do that, I'm eating the princess in a minute. I can't keep her waiting, she's too special.
I've got sunshine on a cloudy day. When it's cold outside,
nothing big. So I guess you say, oh, what can make me feel this way? Oh, my girl, talking about my girl. I've got so much honey, the bees and the bee. I've got all the riches, baby, that one man can need. So I guess you say, oh, what made me feel this way? Oh, my girl, talking about my girl. No fortune or fame. I've got all the riches, baby, that one man can claim. So I guess you say, oh, what can make me feel this way? Oh, my girl, talking about my girl. My girl, talking about my girl, got sunshine on a cloudy day. My girl. Oh, look, someone's left some cheese. Oh, hello, Mouse. Is this yours? Well, I see you've got your friends looking after it very well for you. Let's go.
Thank you for doing that for me, young Master Hickory. Hickory, where are you? Oh, no. Oh, not again. It's ruined. Oh. Oh. Poor Mouse will have to go without. He can't eat that. Lovely. Now then, where was I? Oh yes, I wanted something for old Mr. Hickory's breakfast. I'll just get some cornflakes out of the cupboard. Oh, thank you very much. Here, I thought I saw... No, I can't. Here, when I opened that door, did you see anything?
Yes!
What? Somebody in there?
Yes!
No, it can't.
Yes, it
does. Was there?
Yes!
Shall I have another look?
Yes!
Right. Oh, thank goodness for that. There's nobody there. Oh. I shall have to stop drinking this stuff. Now then, let me see. What else did I want? Some bread. Oh, thank you very much. Hey, there it was again. I don't believe it. Did you see that?
Yes.
There was somebody there, wasn't there?
Yes.
Yes. Right, well, I'll soon sort this out. Come out with your hands up, I'm making a citizen's arrest. Well, did you ever? There's nobody there. Oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear. I've never seen anything like it. Oh, dear. I think I'm having one of me hot flushes. I need something to steady me nerves. Oh. Where do you think he went? In that door?
Yes.
No, in that door.
Yes.
But I just opened. Oh, all right. We'll open that door and see. No, there's nobody there. What shall I do now? Or the other door? Right. No, there's nobody there either. What? Open that door and that door? But I've just opened that door and that door. What? Open them both at once?
Yes!
Well, why didn't you say so? I tell you what I'll do. I'll open both doors at once. Just thought of that. You see? There wasn't anybody there all along. No, there wasn't.
Oh, yes, there was.
Oh, no, there wasn't.
Oh, yes, there was.
Oh, no, there wasn't. And if you don't shut up, we should be keeping this up all night. I've got to get on. Now then, where was I? Oh, I forgot to bring the eggs. Look, don't go away. Just stay there for a moment. I'll only be a sec. I'll go and get the eggs.
Hey, Megabyte! Where's my breakfast? Where is she? Oh, dear. Ah, this must be it. Delicious. Pity there's no more of that. Thanks for breakfast, then, Megabyte. Delicious.
Breakfast? What breakfast? I haven't got it ready yet. Silly old fool. Oh, I suppose you want some breakfast, too. Oh, it's all go, isn't it? Well, you'll just have to make do with that until I can sort you out something nicer later. Here, you're having me on, aren't you? You've already eaten it. He has, hasn't he?
No!
Oh, yes, he has.
Oh, no, he hasn't.
Luke! What? You'd eaten it, hadn't you? Who's eaten it?
Hickory!
Oh, Mr. Hickory! Oh, don't talk so silly. Of course he didn't.
Oh, yes, he did.
It was you, wasn't it?
No.
Well, you'll just have to make do with some of that cheese over there. No, why not? You're saving it for a special occasion. Well, there's nothing else. You can R as much as you like. There's no more until tomorrow.
Aww.
Aww. Oh, he'd wrap me round his little finger if I let him. Dear, oh dear, now where was I? Oh yes, I want some vegetables. They're in that cupboard. Do you think it's safe? Right. nothing in there at all. Yes, you have to scare them. Pretend you're a traffic warden or a well clamper or something.
Timmy, that doesn't sound very nice.
Oh, you'll soon get the hang of it. Go and chase him some more.
If you say so, Superbug.
Ha 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 ha! Everyone's scared of Superbug. Ha! I'm invisible now. Yes, I am. Just you wait and see.
Hi, everybody.
Hi,
time for our elevensies talk. I'll put the kettle on. Now, talk. Old Hickory's just paid me our wages. I'll share it out on here.
You just leave mine on the table while I make the tea.
It's £10, five for you and five for me. I'll leave your share on there.
Here's your tea. And where did you put my money?
It's on the table.
No, it isn't. What have you done with my money?
I put it there. It's gone. You put it in your bag.
No, I haven't.
You must have. Turn out your bag.
Turn out your bag?
Look, this is my money. I put yours on the table.
That's mine. You've got yours.
Give me that back. That's mine. What was that? Don't change the subject. I want my money back.
Look in your bag for yours.
It's mine. I put yours on the table next to my tea.
You didn't pour me out any tea.
It's on the table.
Don't be funny. I want my money back and I want some tea.
He was here. A huge monster.
Where? I can't see anything.
He was in that cupboard.
If he was a huge monster, how did he get in the cupboard?
He shrunk.
I see. So we're looking for a small, huge monster.
What? Don't confuse me.
Here, have you two been playing tricks on Dame Megabyte?
No, somebody's been playing tricks on ours.
She's been at Cooking Sherry again.
Oh, I have not.
Oh, yes, you have.
Oh, no, I haven't.
Oh, yes, you have.
Much. Anyway, there was a horrible monster. There was two horrible monsters, and they ran after me. They were going to eat me.
Don't be silly. Nobody's that hungry.
They chased me up. They chased me down.
Upstairs.
Downstairs. In their nightgowns.
I'm not invisible now. There he is! Get him!
Come back here! I want my money back! Come here!
I'm invisible now.
Good thinking, Superbug.
They're gone.
Thank goodness.
I wasn't frightened of them.
No, was I.
I've heard of putting the clocks forward, but not right across the room.
That's one more clock done for.
Good thinking, Superbug.
Who was that?
Me.
Not me.
It was me.
Oh, I wish he'd stop doing that.
So, who's scared of me now?
I am! Tom!
Yes, if at first you don't succeed.
Don't boo me! Did you see him? He doesn't know how lucky he's going to be soon when he's got me. Still, one step at a time. Virus! Virus!
That's it, no boo. Here I am. You want a progress report.
I want a progress report.
And you want it now.
And I want it now. Oh, it's like having an echo before you speak with him around.
Don't complain, it was your idea.
Well, is my horrible plan in operation?
Everything is going according to plan. All clocks, watches and calendars will soon have stopped. And time will come to a halt. Ha 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 ha!
Good, or should I say bad, bad. Ha!
You do realise that everything has to stop for your plan to work?
Eh?
One tiny piece of apparatus that's left working will take people forward into a new year.
We can't have that happening. Make sure everything is stopped until I get my way.
I will.
I would have put it past that silly fairy queen person to think of something at the last minute.
She's trying to make sure there's a happy ending.
A happy ending? We don't want a happy ending. Oh, no, we don't.
Oh, yes, we do.
Oh, no, we don't.
Oh, yes, we do.
Well, you're not going to get one. Oh, no, you're not.
Oh, yes, we are.
God, they're gone forever, this lot.
What's anything else, boss? I've still got a lot to do.
Yes, I had thought of something before this lot had started. Now, what was it?
You want me to kidnap Tick and Tock.
Ah, I want you to kidnap... Oh, you're doing it again.
I know. I can't help being absolutely brilliant.
He is good, isn't he? You've got to admit, he's very good. Now... Oh, yes, he is. Anyway, the plan is that if we kidnap Tick and Tock, they won't be able to get anything new started. Just in case that silly fairy queen gets any smart ideas at the last minute. Without Tick and Tock, nothing can work.
Right, I'll carry on stopping all the clocks and watches, and then I'll find Tick and Tock, and when I do, I'll grab them. Where do you want me to put them?
Lock them up in my dome. We'll need them once I've got control to get everything started again.
Righto, boss.
What could go wrong with a plan like that? I'm just going to make myself invisible and go along to Hickory's workshop to make sure everything is getting sorted out properly. Or should I mean horribly? They'll never know I'm there, they won't. Now you see me. No, you don't. You can't see me now. No, you can't.
At the palace, all the clocks have stopped. It's strange.
I tried to get them started, but they all kept stopping.
Really?
We've been having trouble with the clocks here as well.
My megabytes kitchen clock exploded.
And there was this strange creature that kept disappearing and reappearing, wasn't there?
Yes!
Ah, now we're getting to it. Magic.
Magic? Magic?
Yes. And if I'm not mistaken, old Greenwich Meantime is behind this. She obviously has something nasty in mind.
Oh, dear.
Something like this has happened before.
Now it's happening again.
Shh. I'm trying to remember. Yes, of course. It was a new year, a long time ago, of course. She got some silly idea that she wanted to marry someone young, brave and handsome, or else she'd start up a whole bad new year. Now, who was it?
Marry Greenwich Meantime. Now, who'd want to do a thing like that?
Yes, of course. I remember now. It was me.
You?
Yes, well, I was young and, well, young in those days.
So you think it could be happening again?
Yes, it might be. I hope not. Caused a lot of trouble then, I can tell you.
Well, what are we going to do?
We've got to do something quick.
Yeah, I'm trying to remember what you did last time.
Well, Father, what did you do to stop her?
No, it's gone. I can't remember.
Think, Father, it's very important.
I know. It was something to do with them.
Yes.
No, sorry, no. Oh, wait!
Yes.
No, sorry, son, it's gone again.
Don't worry, Father, we'll think of something.
Don't.
What was that?
It's Greenwich Meantime. I can feel her presence.
How clever you are, but not clever enough.
She must be invisible.
Yes, I am.
Help me, Pip, I'm scared.
She's over there now.
No, I'm not, I'm here.
And I'm here.
And I'm over here. You're surrounded.
Well, who's that then?
Stop. Enough questions. Virus, get Tick and Tock and take them you know where.
Not to your dreaded dome.
Not there. We don't want to go in there.
Right, Tick and Tock, walk this way.
Right, young Master Hickory. Time you and I got to know each other better. After all, young lovers like to be together. Repeat after me. I am in your power.
You are in my power.
No, you fool. You are in my power.
No, you fool. You are in my power.
I hate pantomimes. Never mind. I've got plenty of time to deal with you later. Now, a little spell to set things right. All clocks shall stop this very night. All computers will go down. How Bill Gates is going to frown. And when my happy bad new year starts, I'll reign supreme in all your hearts. A time for evil has now begun. Oh, won't we all have lots of fun? Young Hickory, you shall reign with me, and very happy we shall be.
The witch has cast a spell on us.
The clock stopped.
Yes.
And Tick and Tock have gone.
The witch has taken them.
But we can't start up the clocks again. again without Tick and Tock?
I think that's the whole idea, Hickory.
But what are we going to do, Father?
We're going to Royal Perkins!
I think there's a bit of a problem, Hickory.
You can say that again.
Do I have to?
No, I just... We know what the problem is.
Well, what are you doing about it? Sorting it out? That sort of thing?
What happened? Father says that Greenwich Mean Time has put a spell on all the clocks and taken Tick and Tock to stop us from starting them up again. Oh no, what are we going to do?
Help! Me souffle's collapsed! I've got no clock to time anything with. My eggs are all hard boiled. Cancel the new year!
Calm down,
Damon. Oh, I don't want to calm down. I want to have a nervous breakdown.
I wish someone would put a spell on her.
Oh, we're all doomed. Doomed. We're doomed.
We'll get Tick and Tock back.
She'll have taken them to her dreaded dome.
Oh.
Right. And we've got to find a way to stop the witch from ruining our new year.
If only there was a fairy queen in these pantomimes.
I know, but I haven't seen one of you.
No.
I wonder if our friends have seen one. Shall we ask them?
Yes.
Excuse me. Have you seen a fairy queen anywhere?
Yes!
God, they've seen one!
Well, then summon her to the royal personage!
You don't summon fairy queens, Father. You sort of ask them nicely.
What a strange idea.
But we don't know her name. Do you know her name?
Fairy Sunfire.
Did you say Fairy One Smile?
Yes,
no, that's the Fairy Five Miles.
Fairy Sundial!
Oh, yes. I remember a Fairy Sundial from somewhere.
Shall we call her?
Yes.
Right, on three!
Three! Fairy Sundial!
Oh. Ooh. Oh.
Oh. I gather something is amiss, and you want me to do the bits.
Fairy Queen, help us if you can. We hope you've got a useful plan.
To bring the witch to her defeat and make our panto smooth and sweet.
You don't all have to squeak and rhyme. Your normal senses would be fine.
Thanks, Fairy Sundial.
Do you have a plan for us, then?
The witch's power is strong and great. She plans for you a gruesome fate. Go quickly to her dreaded dome. Tick and Tock must be brought home. Without delay, go, waste no time.
Pot straight upon the Jubilee line.
Good day.
Right, everyone, off we go.
Just wait till I get my hands on her.
Kingdom safe again and spread happiness
enjoying yourself? You're in my dreaded dome. What did Peter Mandelson say? Get on with your work.
It's our happy hour.
Happy hour? Slaves don't have happy hours. I'll turn you into frogs. That'll be a riveting experience. Ha! I mean time. Get off! Not bad, is it, eh? There's no place like Dome. I just turned one of my big books upside down and stuck some broomsticks in it to hold it up. From the air, it looks like an unidentified frying object. Then some magic to make it huge, and there it was. Took me a couple of minutes. Not like that other lot. Anyway, where's Virus? Virus!
What are you looking for then, boss?
I'm looking for Virus.
He's here.
No! Don't creep up on me like that!
Sorry.
Here, you're not getting all dozy again, are you?
Well, I could do with a nap. It's very tiring being like this, you know.
Go and take your vitamin tablets.
Here's your prisoners.
We want political asylum.
And diplomatic immunity.
Oh, shut your faces. Put them to work with the slaves.
Oh, no, that's cruel, that is.
Oi, I thought you were going to sort him out.
I haven't had the time. I've been stopping all these clocks and watches and things.
Well, make sure you do. We don't want him messing things up. Now, next on my list is young Hickory. You must get him here.
There's no need. He's on his way.
What?
He's on his way.
Oh, he can't wait to see me, the impetuous boy.
He'll soon sort you out.
We don't like it here. We want to go home.
Will you shut up?
He's coming to rescue Chicken Top.
Goody. That's what they think. He's my early warning system. I've thought of everything. Oh, yes, I have.
Oh, no, you haven't.
Oh, yes, I have.
Oh, no, you haven't.
Oh, I hate pantomimes. Now, when Hickory gets here, I want everything sorted for the wedding. Our wedding. Me and Hickory. I hope he's not late. He mustn't keep his beautiful bride waiting. Well, they always have a wedding at the end of a pantomime. It's tradition. You all want a wedding, don't you?
Yes!
Look, do you want a wedding or not?
Yes!
That's all I need, an audience that can't make up its mind. Take these two away and come back for your instructions.
Right, Chicken Talk, walk this way.
What, again? The Dome. Never had one there before. Well, it's got to pay for itself, hasn't it?
He'll be back in a minute.
Right. I know. I'll get him to go over to that cheese and he'll get bit by that mouse. That'll liven him up. Here, come here.
Yes, boss?
Do you like cheese?
Oh, yes, I like cheese. Very tasty is cheese.
Well then, help yourself over there.
Oh, thanks very much. Is it all right if I have some cheese?
No. Of course it's all right.
No.
Would I get you into trouble?
Yes.
Are you sure it's all right?
Of course, it's there for anybody. No. Go on.
Is it all right?
No.
touch of rheumatism then, boss?
No, I'm auditioning for Long John Silver, you fool.
Right, I'll get you a parrot then.
Come back here! Where are the prisoners?
They're all safely locked up.
Good. Right, now take positions when Hickory arrives. Here's the plan.
Yes, well, all ears.
Don't tempt me.
Boss?
Right. When you see them, you grab them.
That's the plan?
Yes, good, isn't it?
Well, it's very simple.
But it has to be with you two working it. Now, let's sing our song.
Checked her wedding dress. By this time he needs a rest. CD-ROM is playing up downstairs. Which he needs her beauty sleep.
Ah. I've got a date with Hickory that I wanna keep.
Ah, don't. In the middle of our street. Ah, don't. In the middle of our don't. It has a growl. There's always something happening, and it's usually quite loud. We ain't that house proud. Bits and pieces all around, being clean is not allowed. Ah, don't. In the middle of our street. Ah, don't. In the middle of our. Ah, don't. In the middle of our street. Ah, don't. In the middle of our plan is set to work. Hickory is on his way to Kentucky, safely locked downstairs. When she wants a wedding kiss.
Ah. I've got a date with Hickory, I'm not going to miss.
What's this about a wedding and who's getting married?
You are. silly boy. You're going to marry me, and she is going to work with the slaves.
Oh, no.
Take them away!
Hickory! I love you! I love you too, Colleen!
Love? Huh. What's love got to do with it?
Now, look here, witchy. It's not that I don't,
find me strangely attractive.
Yes. I'm sure that one day someone or something will come along and
all for my irresistible charms.
Something like that.
It's no good, Hickory. I've made up my mind.
And I've made up my mind. I won't marry you.
I'll turn Colleen into an ugly frog.
I've changed my mind.
I knew you'd see sense. I have such wonderful powers of persuasion. Now, we need to settle a few details.
You're supposed to be helping me guard the prisoners. Oh, mice! Oh no! I hate mice! There's millions of them! Ah! Ah!
Can I be on their side?
Yes!
Great! Come on, let's go rescue these.
the others. I know where they are.
I don't care. Everything is going ahead as planned. Young Hickory is being fitted with a splendid suit with all the trimmings. No expense spared. Then we can get on with the celebrations. Pantos aren't so bad after all. You can all watch the wedding and you can all clear off home.
Tut, tut. We immortals all should speak in verse. You're very bad at getting worse.
I can't be bothered with all that stuff. It's boring and I've had enough. It's time for everything to change. A wedding I have just arranged with Hickory, the blushing groom. For you, I fear, there is no room. So before you put me in a rage, I ask you kindly to leave the stage.
Oh no, my mission has just begun.
See how free your prisoners do run.
Now we've got to think of a way of rescuing the others.
Where's my poor daughter locked up?
And my son, young Hickory, and Chicken Talk.
Brave lad, your son. See how he stood up to that horrible witch.
Yes, but how are we going to get them out? Oh.
I see you need my help again. That witch is being quite a pain.
Can you help us to set the others free?
Well, some magic we will need to make a special rescue bid succeed. A cunning mission must be planned. Now let me see what is at hand. Ah, I see something in my shoes.
Cheese will tempt the guards out, that sort of thing.
Yes, the guards will enter one at a time, and you must catch them with the rhyme.
That smells nice.
Yes, pity your cooking doesn't smell like that. They make a fun.
Do you mind?
The guards will enter one at a time, and you must catch them with the rhyme. After that, it's up to you. Remember this, my final clue. Tired and time, for no man waits. Solve the clue and celebrate!
Rhyme? What's rhyme?
Oh, that's obvious. Hickory dickory dock.
Of course. You must help us.
Here comes one now.
Mummy,
cooked my favourite.
Hickory dickory dock!
Yummy, yummy, I'll fill my tummy.
The mouse ran up the clock.
Food.
The clock struck one.
Oh, I'm starving.
Down the mouse run.
I smell cheese, lovely cheese.
Hickory dickory dock.
Oh, he says, not this one. She's on our side now.
Spoiled sport.
Now, CD-ROM, can you take us to where the prisoners are?
That's going to be difficult. The witch is guarding young Hickory and Tick and Tock, but I can show you where the princess is.
Well, let's rescue her first, then.
Right, this way.
Strange going on, and I bet that fairy sundial is behind it. Something smells. It's that cheese. If you think I'm going near it to set you lot off, you're wrong.
Tick and Tock are still locked up.
So is young Hickory.
Good. But all the rest have escaped.
What? You useless lot. I'll stop it out of your wages.
But you don't pay us any wages.
Well, I'm not surprised. Well, never mind about them. The important ones are still locked up. Come on, and don't boo.
I've come to cheer you all up. And I brought you all some of my lovely homemade cakes.
Oh, no!
Oh, yes. These contain a unique culture called Bifidus Digestivum, which is clinically proven to help improve your natural digestive transit. If taken every day for 100 years, as part of a calorie control diet, because you're worth it. down on. No, come on, eat up, everybody.
Oh, no.
Come on. Well, that's the wrong attitude, you see. What you want to do is you want to think of a few of your favourite things, and then you won't feel so bad. Dewdrops on noses and whiskey on kippers, smelly old toesies in smelly old slippers, mouldy old cabbages pickled in brine. These are some things that are favourites of mine. Horrible mixtures to make you disgusted, ice cream in gravy and burgers in custard, worms fried in batter to dunk in your wine. These are some things that are favourites of mine. Squashy bananas all slimy and slippy, maggoty apples and oranges pippy, lemons as sour as when picked from the vine. These are some things that are favourites of mine. When the cat flaps, when the cow pats, when I'm feeling low, I just spend some time with these favourites of mine and then have another go. Dewdrops on noses and whiskey on clippers, smelly old toesies in smelly old slippers, mouldy old cabbages pickled in brine. These are some things that are favourites of mine. Horrible mixtures to make you disgusted, ice cream in gravy and burgers in custard, worms fried in batter to dunk in your wine. These are some things that are favourites of mine. Squashy bananas, all slimy and slippy, maggoty apples and oranges pippy, lemons as sour as when picked from the vine. These are some things that are favourites of mine. When the cat flaps, when the cow pats, when I'm feeling low, I just spend some time with these favourites of mine and carry on with the show. You see, you should all be cheerful like me. Oh, I'm so unhappy. I wish all the clocks would start up again and everything would go back to the way it used to be. But that witch, she's ruined everything.
Oh, she's certainly ruined this.
What?
Or somebody has.
Oh, no, that was me. And anyway, how can you be thinking about food at a time like this? We've got to go and rescue young Master Ickory and Tick and Tock. Ow!
We can't do that, Dame Megabyte. The witch's power's too strong, and she's got them all locked up in her deepest dungeon. And I love Ickory so much.
Oh, did you, my dear? Why didn't anybody tell me? Oh dear, oh dear. The clocks have stopped. The New Year's cancelled. My daughter's unhappy. The first pantomime with an unhappy ending. You might as well all go home. That sort of thing. They can't do that. They've paid to see a happy ending, haven't you?
Yes!
But with everything stopped, the witch has won. Wait a minute.
What is it?
If the witch has won, why isn't she here gloating?
She's probably trying to make herself beautiful for the wedding.
No, let me think. All the clocks have stopped, including the master clock and all the computers. But something must still be going, don't you see? If everything had stopped, we wouldn't be moving, would we?
I can't see anything still going.
I don't understand.
No, nothing's going.
Everything stopped, all right.
I'm trying to remember something the Fairy Queen said.
Yes, Fairy Sundial, her last clue, she said...
Oh, Sundial! That's it! Fiddlers, outside, quick! Go and check on the sundial!
Oh, I go and check on it too.
Yes, the Fairy Queen said something about time and tide.
Waits for no one. That was it.
That's right. If time really had stopped, we wouldn't be moving, would we?
Of course.
But the witch wasn't able to stop everything after all.
No.
Does that mean we can get young Ickory back?
Have our New Year celebration after all?
Well, only if we can get the clock started and break the witch's spell.
How can we do that?
We'll need some help.
Yeah.
But we haven't got Tick and Tock here.
It's working! The sun is
working!
It's working! It's working! The
wonderful. It's working, it's working.
Well, I think she's trying her personal best.
If only we can get the master clock to start.
Yes, we'll need some help.
Yes. They can help us.
Yes. But how?
Well, once, a long time ago, I used to have Tick and Tock's job, you see.
Don't get it, old boy.
I used to start the clocks up. Now, with all our combined energy, perhaps we can break the witch's power.
Oh, that's not going to be easy. Oh,
but we must try.
You'll help us, won't you?
Yes.
There you go. What do they have to do?
They have to go tick, tock.
That's simple enough. Even I could do that.
No, no, but they have to sway as well. Like a pendulum.
That lot will never manage that.
Give us a sherry.
You can do it, can't you?
Yes.
Fiddlers, help Hickory.
Right, everyone listening? Okay, you all have to shout out tick, tock. But you have to sway as well, like a pendulum. Okay, so now, when we sway to this side, you all say tick. And when you all sway to this side, you all say, oh, you're better than the last lot.
And I'll keep an eye on the master clock to see if it starts to work.
Right. On three, then.
Three. Tick, tock. Tick, tock. Tick, tock. Tick,
it's starting, it's starting.
Tick,
keep going.
Tock. Tick, tock. Tick, tock.
We're winning.
Tick, tock.
It's astounding. The time is fleeting. Madness takes its toll. But listen closely.
But not for much longer.
I've had to take control. I remember starting the clocks many years ago. When the clock sounds would hit me.
We made the clock start again. We made the clock start again.
Just a sway to the left,
and then a sway to the right. Put your hands on your hips, you bend your knees in time. And it's a tick and tock that really drives you insane. We made the clock start again. We made the clock start again.
It's so dreamy, so fantasy dreamy. But you can't see me, no, not at all. Well secluded, I'll see all.
With a bit of a mind flip,
you're into the time slip.
And nothing can ever be of the same.
You spaced out some sensation, like you're under sedation.
We made the clock start again.
Down the street just having a think when this snake of a guy gave me an evil wink. He took me up, he took me by surprise. He stared at me and I felt a change. Time meant nothing, never would again.
We made the clock start again. We made the clock start again.
Just a sway to the left.
And then it's way to the right. Put your hands on your hips. You bend your knees in tight. And it's a tick and talk. chattering, say, hey, hey, hey. We made the clock start again. We made the clock start again.
You forgot one thing.
No, I had every clock, watch and computer stopped.
There is a power beyond your sway and a clock you never could delay.
What? Fairy Sundial controls natural time. Don't you see? That can never be stopped by you.
It looks like you lost Witchy Watches.
But how did you get these things started? I have Tick and Tock locked up.
These good people helped.
The power of their good overcame your evil.
I knew you were unreliable.
Hi, everybody!
Hi, Tick and Tock!
Hey, how did you get out?
It was very strange.
Everything started to move, and then the doors came open.
And out we came.
That must have been about the time that the clock started up again and all that goodness started to work.
You see how brightly good can burn? A lesson for us all to learn.
Oh, I hate pantomimes!
Temper, temper.
Does that mean young Hickory escaped as well?
Wait, I'm not finished yet. Virus, come here! Virus, sort these people out. Look them up and then get all the clocks stopped again.
I don't think I can do that.
Why not?
Because I'm tired of being chased around by him. And I've used up all my energy turning off all these clocks and things. And I've run out of silicon chips.
Excuses. You always were useless. I'll promote CD-ROM to your job and get rid of you. CD-ROM!
Hello!
Look, I'm promoting you. This is your big chance. Look these people up and you can have his job.
Oh, no, I don't think so. I don't like being horrible.
You don't like being horrible? What is wrong with the youth of today?
You have your answer loud and clear. Your evil spent, it would appear. And now, please kindly leave our play, and we'll get a happy ending underway.
Just you wait till next year and don't boo!
Hi, everyone!
Hi!
Hickory, you're safe!
Yes, suddenly everything started to move. The doors came open, and out I came.
Hickory! I was most impressed by your defiance of the witch. Is there anything I can do to repay you?
We think there is.
Majesty, the princess and I love each other very much, and we would like your consent to get married.
Delighted, my boy. You should have asked me sooner. And now, let the celebrations begin.
Yay!
And let's start off with a royal wedding.
Yay!
Are going to be the top.
We'll all sing the verse together first, and then my lot, we'll carry on with the TikTok bit.
And we'll go back to the verse. And of course, there will be a prize for the loudest sigh. Ready?
Hickory, hickory dock, the mouse ran up the clock. The clock struck one, the mouse ran down. Hickory, hickory dock, tick tock, tick tock, tick.
Ready? Hickory, hickory dock,
the mouse ran up the clock.
Thank you.
happy new year has begun. We bring a time for joy and cheer to each and every person here. Ring out the bells with all their might. All go safely home this night.
1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. We'll see when it's on, join behind. We'll have some fun when the clock strikes wrong. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. We're gonna rock, rock, rock till morning. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. When the clock strikes 2, 3 and 4, and the bells go down, we'll yell for more. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. We're gonna rock, rock, rock till morning.
Thank you.